It was one of the biggest television moments of 2022 when after 36
What are we talking about now? Oh, there it is.
Moved on.
Ramsay Street.
Yep. When after 37 years we said goodbye to our favourite Neighbours, but in the twist of fate and as a gift from the TV gods, the show was saved.
So will there be a new look Ramsay Street? Will Harold still be open? Are Scott and Charlene coming back? Let's find out from one of its favourite residents of all time, Dr. Carl Kennedy, aka Alan Fletcher, joins us from our Melbourne studio. Welcome back. Lovely to see you.
Hi, Larry. Hi, Kylie. Love to see you.
Now, we had the big Neighbours farewell. We all cried as we said goodbye. But now, in a twist, it's coming back. Can you explain what happened and what's it going to look like now?
Well, I'm going to be honest with you and say that I think the Neighbours that comes back will be as good, if not better, than the Neighbours that went away. That's the first thing I can tell you, but I don't know much more beyond that. Of course, Amazon Freevee, which is the Amazon's free streaming service, stepped in to help save Neighbours. And, of course, it's broadcast here in Australia too by one of your rival networks, as you'd probably know.
Oh, well, that's the end of the interview, mate.
Yeah, nice catching up.
Yes. Thank you very much.
So, we know that you and your on-screen wife, Jackie Woodburn, that are both returning.
Who else is confirmed?
Well,
we have confirmation on Stephen Dennis and Ryan Maloney at this stage, and all the others are pending. In fact, to be honest with you, I've been rushing around so busy myself, I haven't actually had any chance to catch up with the Neighbours producers to find out any more. But I have to say also, things are very top secret out there at Nunawading in terms of what the new Neighbours will be.
All right. We're trying to get those answers before it pops up on another channel anyway. Aside from Neighbours, we've got to talk music. We know you love your music. You have a new album out. It's called The Point. And we've got a little bit here. Let's have a listen to the song Fish and Whistle. Here we go.
Oh, fish and whistle, whistle and fish. Eat everything that you put on your dish. And when you get through, we'll make a big wish that we never have to do this again. Again.
I just want to jump in my ute and smash through the boom gate to the car park. This is a cover of one of your favourite artists, John Prine, of course. This is Americana country sound. Is it all through the album?
It is, very much so. I'm very, very influenced by John Prine. Prine, of course, famously wrote a lot of songs that are comic songs as well as a lot of deep and very poignant songs. And I've followed that same trend myself. I have songs that address, you know, love and loss and the meaning of life, and others that sing and glorify the benefits of having a good lie in bed. So I do mix it up a lot. And it's got a very country Americana feel to it.
Can we talk about track number 8 on the album? So this is a duet, and it's special for an important reason. Tell us what that reason is.
Well, my beautiful wife, Jennifer Hansen, who, of course, was at Smooth FM reading breakfast news for 9 years, it was, has recently retired from that to come on the road with me to play music. And we wrote this song together because it's a relationship song. And what we've found is a lot of relationships founder because people want to blame somebody in the relationship. So this song, Somebody, is actually our way of deflecting blame. We don't sit there and say, oh, you did this or you did that. We just go, somebody didn't lock the door last night. And it's a way of actually quite in an amusing way of just dealing with some of the issues of blame in relationships.
What's it like collaborating with your wife?
What's it like being somebody?
Well, I am somebody more often than Jennifer is. Jen plays keys in my band, which is also comprised of other members of a band called Lachlan Bryan and the Wilds. And Jen plays keys, we write together, we rehearse every day together, and this new foray into music that Jennifer and I are doing together gives us an opportunity to be together all the time. We're touring the UK coming up for 2 weeks, playing music there. We were in Tamworth this year together, so it's absolutely golden for our relationship to be able to do this together.
Oh, I love that you're doing that. Give Jen our love as well. Now, you have an album launch party in St Kilda next week, then you're off to the UK for a whole stack of shows. The reception over there is huge, and this is what some Australians don't understand. That whole Neighbours thing over there is massive, right?
It is. I'm heading over, first of all, to do the Neighbours celebration tour, which was going to be the Neighbours farewell tour, I have to say. So there's six of us heading over to the UK to do that tour, and then I'll do my music tour for a couple of weeks, as well as playing in Belfast with my music. And as you say, George Lane, for the launch, the Australian launch, I'm going to plug away here, Larry, if you don't mind. I'm playing on this Saturday, actually, down at George Lane, the 18th, from 3 till 6, launching the album. So love to see you down at George Lane if you're in Melbourne.
Alan, you have got it all going on. Hey, there's just something we wanted to touch on. We don't often talk hair care with our guests, but I know that you are keen to talk about this, and this is your alopecia, because there's been an update.
I'll take the slot. Now, I lost every single hair on my face and head, as the last episode of Neighbours showed. You know, I even lost my eyebrows and eyelashes, which was pretty freaky, I have to say. And you know, being an older bloke, I dealt with it. But a lot of young people suffer very badly if they get this sort of alopecia, which is areata, and they can be terribly, terribly, you know, hounded by their peers. Mm. But mercifully, with some very innovative treatments which helped to suppress the immune system, my hair, it's coming back. I'm not doing too bad these days.
Hey, you look great.
Yeah, thank you. So it's been very, very encouraging. It's been a year-long process, actually. It was about February last year that I started to lose all my hair, and I lost it quite quickly. So for anyone out there who's got alopecia, my heart goes out to you, because I know how distressing it can be, and there are treatments available, and there's more and more research being done. So, yes, hopefully one day they'll be able to cure it.
Or maybe they can look you up and you can point them in the right direction of what worked for you, because I know it's heartbreaking for people who are affected. So good to catch up. Yeah.
Oh, wonderful. Thank you. And seriously, Kylie, if anybody does want to chat to me at any stage about the alopecia or anything, then they can through my website. It's just alanfletcher.net. They can always chat to me. I answer all my emails.
Yeah. All right, mate. We've got to go, because we can't let you plug one more thing in this segment. you have reached your limit and beyond, my friend. Good to talk to you, Alan. Thank you, mate.
Thanks, you're both awesome. Thank you.
Alan Fletcher's new album is called The Point, and it is available to stream or download right now.
Oh, great cut. Look at that great cover.
Excellent.